massive 9F steam locos, each hauled almost 1,200 tons of freight right across the country. With 10 driving wheels, these monsters raced up to and even beyond the 50-mile-an-hour mainline limit.
You just to look back at the train and see how the guard's brake was riding, see how the wagons were riding. And if the wagons were riding all right, you'd perhaps go 5 or 6 miles over your limit.
Especially if you drove an express.
You'd start with a full train from Birmingham, and you could take 60 wagons then, all the way to Carlisle.
This 200-mile trip took 8 hours, in which the fireman shoveled a back-breaking 15 tons of coal. The driver just kept his hand on the regulator and enjoyed himself.
Seeing the seasons change and seeing the scenery change, he went through different counties. He went through the Midland counties, all nice green fields till he got to about Chesterfield. Then it was all pit heads and forges and foundries all the way to Leeds. And once you got through Leeds, you come into some wonderful country. All the way up to Skipton, through the Yorkshire Dales. Then when you got to Settle Junction, you started to climb over the mountain. It was a very big long climb all the way to Bleemore. Trains with the cauliflowers, peas, cabbage, they weren't very heavy. But the plum trains, they were very, very heavy. Then across the top it went level, and when you got past Aysgill, you were downhill all the way to Appleby, and then you was up and down all the way from Appleby to Carlisle.
While Tom Wootton crossed the country, many railwaymen never left the Midlands. Introduced in 1954, the 9F was a development of a 1930s loco. Typically, the crews loved them, but then Tom Wootton has never even driven a car.
Yeah. Well, we're going now, Tom. How long is it since you've had a go?
30 years.
30 years. Well, are you going to have a go now, then?
Yeah, go on, then.
Come on, then.
10 mile an hour.
10 mile an hour until we get up to the bridge.
All right. It feels as though I've never been away from them. It feels great.
Tom was a top-length driver, a king of the road. His loco was the peak of British steam train engineering, and it looked as though it had been scaled at just the right time. With industrial output still soaring, BR's 251 9Fs gave capacity a welcome boost. The most famous 9F was the Evening Star, the last steam loco built for British Railways. When it was launched in 1960, slower rail freight services were facing stiff competition from trucks and even planes. BR was operating at a loss. So a plan was devised to prune the network and concentrate on the fast and lucrative mainline monsters.
When people lie asleep in bed, it's then I book on at the shed. Prepare me engine, take on call to journey on the iron road. It's up the shed to shunting yard, exchange a few words with the guard. 40 wagons make the train, a green light blows, we're right away. The signal's gleaming through the dark, the steam gate needles on the mark. The tea can warms up on the hob and the engine's gaffer of the job. The fireman in the firebox glow swings a shovel to and fro. Jack's injector cracks the coal, I'll give a more steam, lad, watch a roll. We hop the twig through town and shire, the chimney belching smoke and fire. Our destination comes in view and the night is almost halfway through. And now relieved by another crew, it's into the cabin and make a brew. A yarn and a smoke when you bet you snap, there's half hour left but to take a little nap. The train we work back's at the peg, it's time to rise and show a leg. Come stir yourself mate, rise and shine, or I'll get papers for losing time. And now back home and off to bed. Farewell a while, you loco shed. When the daylight's gone and the night has come, I'll be back again for another night run.